Would you like to adjust your playback preferences of Final Cut Pro?
Playback preferences affect the playback and rendering performance in Final Cut Pro. Let's start by opening up the preference window by navigating to Final Cut Pro, then Preferences, or use the shortcut Command Comma. In the preference window, click on the Playback tab. First, we have the rendering section. Here, you can toggle background rendering on and off. Rendering your footage, make sure you get smooth, high-quality playback. But keep in mind, having background rendering turned on may slow down performance. Having this toggled on automatically renders your project whenever the system is idle. You can also set the amount of time your system is idle before Final Cut Pro begins background rendering. This is a great feature if you still want background rendering turned on, but don't want Final Cut Pro to constantly render while you're editing. In the Render GPU dropdown, you can choose which graphic processing unit to use when rendering or sharing. This choice only affects rendering and sharing, not performance. Any real-time edits will use the default GPU. In the Playback section, we can select if we want to create optimized media for multi-cam clips. You may want to select this if you see a drop in playback quality or performance while working with multi-cam clips. If you'd like to learn more about creating optimized media or multi-cam clips, be sure to check out the related videos linked in the description below. Next, you can choose whether you want Final Cut Pro to warn you when frames are dropped during playback. You can toggle any of these three options on or off, which can be helpful in diagnosing what's causing your frames to drop. But if you prefer, you can have these toggled off so Final Cut Pro doesn't warn you at all.
Ooh, today is gonna be the day that we're gonna learn some Final Cut, baby.
Moving on, we can change the pre-roll and post-roll durations. This lets us set the amount of time when using the play around command, or use the shortcut Shift? The play around command lets you play back your project around where your playhead is positioned. So if our playhead is positioned here, the pre-roll duration will set the amount of time to play before the playhead's location. And the post-roll duration will set the amount of time to play after the playhead location. If we use the play around shortcut, Shift? The project will play back according to the pre-roll and post-roll durations we set. Next, the player background will let you choose a background for your viewer. The color you choose will be visible if you have partially transparent clips, or clips that don't fill the frame completely. By default, the player background is set to black. In this example, if we reposition our video a little too far, we can see a tiny sliver of black in the background. If we export the video as is, we'll see this line in our exported video, which in this case is not what we want. Zooming out, this can be difficult to see because the black background blends in with the dark Final Cut Pro interface. We can change the background to white, which helps, but the white background may potentially blend in with brighter videos. The checkerboard is a great option that is more noticeable.
Playback preferences? Muy importante.
Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.
ting. Well, I reckon you've been looking for more tutorials. Am I right or am I right? Well, we've got your answers right over here at Pixel Film Studios, where there's free tutorials for Final Cut Pro.